I say at the beginning of the pattern for the corner to corner, inside out corner to corner blanket, that it all started with a shawl. And this shawl was the result of that process. I wanted to be able to use a color changing yarn and do two corner to corner, well, they end up to be triangles, side to side, and just be able to work up one side and down the other, and then back and forth. And this was the result. And it's the only project I've completed with it because they take a bit longer. And I got sidetracked in the middle of making this, I got sidetracked and started wondering if, this took a bit over one skein of Mandela Baby to complete. Okay, we're gonna go in, out, there we go. Okay. To start off a blanket, or a shawl actually, these are the two setup rows. And basically we're going to start working on, okay, the beginning of this video is going to be the same for both corner to corner hats and inside out corner to corner blankets, because they both start exactly the same way, and it's silly to make two videos to do it. So I will use the beginning of this video for both hats and for the blankets. And I don't have any pictures of any blankets because I've not made any yet. I guess we could go out just a bit. Yeah. And we'll show you the hats. This one's worked with the remnants of a Mandela, and I made it extra long. The cool thing about these is that they're very, very stretchy. So this one would basically fit any size, well, with the color, any size woman's head. I don't know that a guy would want mint. But it can be rolled up or down, and if you stretch it, it gets skinnier. Kind of like those, I don't know, what did they call them? The finger traps that we used to get at the fair. Yeah. Anyway, that one is with just the bottom done with no evening out and no border. This one was done with Karen Simply Soft, and it has been evened out, and then a modified half double crochet front loop, back loop for the bottom, which is pretty stretchy. And also I made it long enough that it can be turned up for smaller heads. This one's not yet complete. This is a heavier weight worsted yarn. Quite thick, and so it's definitely on the larger side. And it's been evened off, and I've started a border. I just got sidetracked. This one was the very first one that I successfully completed. And the video today, I am going to be showing you with larger hooks, but for a hat, I learned that you need to start with the very smallest hook that you can use with that particular yarn. And I started with the yarn that was appropriate for, you know, what the label said. And it's too big and bulky, and it also ends up having these bulges. It's not noticeable when you put it on your head, if your head's big enough, that is, like mine, donation card. So I did learn a lot from this very first one and started, this is Karen Simply Soft, and I think I started it with a either a 4.0 or a 4.5, and eventually went up to a 5 in degrees. You know, if I started with 4, then I went to 4.5 and then to 5 at the biggest part. Because when you're making this as a hat, you are limited to 16, well, here, 16 blocks around around this one. This one has 20 blocks around, so this is 80 stitches. It's a much thinner yarn than this, and so I've been doing this with a 4.0, and I've gone up to 4.5 with this one, and that's it, because it has 80 stitches around, so you don't want to make it too huge. And this one is successfully done also. And this one, again, it's a little bit thicker than, not noticeably, but a tiny bit thicker yarn than Karen Simply Soft. This is Premier Basic Stitch Anti-Pilling. I love this yarn. It feels silky and is kind of shiny, reminiscent of the Karen Simply Soft. A little bit more expensive. It's very, very nice yarn. And I, again, started this one with because it's a little thicker, I think I started with a 4.5 and went up to 16 stitches. It's a 4-weight worsted yarn. And I went up to 16 of the blocks. So this one's 64 stitches around. So I think I went up to 5mm hook. But you can see that even with only 64, it will stretch to fit pretty much any head. And if you have a smaller head, you can always turn it up on the bottom. All of these are for donations,
my process, so
and I recommend it especially for the hats, is to use the corner-to-corner technique that uses 5 chains and to start a new block and chaining up 2 to make the next block. And that gives you a smaller gap here, which is what I prefer. The pattern will work with the normal corner-to-corner technique where you chain 6 to start a new block and chain up 3, but it will give you bigger gaps, and I do not recommend it for the hat unless you want big gaps in your hat. Okay, and this is my little trick for not having a big knot here. Especially on this, I really don't, you can, if you're doing a different project, you can kind of crochet over it, but this is going to be right in the very center of the blanket or in the center of the top of the head. So I want less of a knot there. So that's what I do. You can do what you want. Okay, block 2. You either turn your yarn and chain or turn the first block and chain, or wait and turn it after. Either way will work. 2, 3, 4, 5. You make your second block with 3 double crochets. And this is key. Turning it means you keep this one facing you because it has the working yarn and so forth, and you have to flip the other one over the first block and slip stitch into the back between the chain two and the first of the double crochets. And join with a slip stitch, chain up two for your second block of row two. And we'll lay this down. Okay, this is section one of the process. Our goal now is to get this working yarn from up here down to here. To do that, in other videos I chained two, or slip stitched two. That was not a slip stitch. There we go. We'll do it in there. Slip stitch one in the side of the double crochet, slip stitch into the gap between the first block and the last one that you just made. Then I find a couple of the loops here. On this one, I just find one, and then I go into the very, very center. Okay? And that is section one completed. Now on to section two. I'm gonna get this out of the way. And we start a new block just like we start a new row. Chaining. Working our three double crochets. And this is essential. In turning this, you don't want to go this way. You need to flip it over so that you're working into the back. And you are joining into the side where you just did your slip stitches down. And you should be able to feel, if you're confused, this one is not bulky. This one where you did your slip stitches is a little more bulky. You join between this block and the one on top there with a slip stitch, chain two, and join anywhere you can find a couple of loops up there. Doesn't really matter. And chain two. Now, if this part were not here, you would be chaining up five or six and working your new block. So basically this ends up to be pretty much the same thing. I've chained two, and then the slip stitch is another, and then my two more chains. Now I turn my work and I work around the chain two that I had just attached. And that is block one of row two of the second section. I slip stitch to join to block one of section two, chain up two to finish the final block of section two. So, this is identical to the way it looks for the shawl. No, actually, this way. You can see they're the same. So, on to section three. Process is exactly the same as moving the yarn down To start section two, we have to move the yarn down to start section three. Doing a slip stitch there, joining with a slip stitch there, and here on these, I do two, and I like to get just one loop so it's not too bulky. I can find another one. There's one. And then I also slip stitch right into the center. So I'm adding one. And I start section three the same way you would start a new row. There we go. Our block one of section three is done, and again the cue is that you're going to turn this and make sure that you are joining to the side that you just did the slip stitches, and you can tell the difference just by the feel. This one's thicker. Join with a slip stitch and do the same thing you did when you started row two and section two. Come up here and join anywhere you can find a couple of loops. Chain two, turn your work, and work around that chain two that you joined before. And there is. Okay, so we're going to join to the first block of section three, just like a normal corner to corner project, chain two, and do the last block of section three. Okay, for section four, we're going to do something a little bit different, but getting our yarn down to the center is going to be the same. I'm going to find a loop on the side and do a slip stitch into between the two blocks, find one loop for a slip stitch. Another single loop for maybe, there we go, for another slip stitch, and then going again right into the center. See how neat that looks that way, where it's all going to the center? Okay, now, you're going to have to take my word for it that this is what works. You cannot do what we did before. On the other three sections, we turned it and connected here. For this one, we need to chain two and connect in between. This is section one, section two, section three. We need to chain two, connect in between block one and of row one of section one and the first block of row two of section one. So we're going to chain two, slip stitch to join between them, do our chain two, and then we're going to turn our work and work around the chain two that we just made and joined. Not the chain two over here, but this one down here. Okay, that puts us in position to now connect to section three on the side that we did the slip stitch. We do that, and chain two, connect somewhere up here, two loops, and chain two. Turn and do block one of the second row of section four. Do our chain up two, and then we do our three double crochets around the chain two of block one of section four. Okay. Now, both for the hat and for a blanket, you will notice that because we've been chaining two, we have fairly small gaps between the two where they're joined. But if you come up here and you join with a slip stitch like normal, this over time is going to be a very noticeable gap running all the way up the side. So what I took to doing is finding basically the slip stitch. I'm going to put this into there, and finding two loops of that slip stitch. I'm going to bring it up so it shows. Okay. Okay. And in that slip stitch, we are going to make a half double crochet. And then we're going to join. Okay, now we need to look at this. Looks kind of like a misshapen four-leaf clover. This is the setup rows for both the hat and the blanket. And in order for these setup rows to work, you need to pay attention to the fact that on each one of these, we'll call them peaks or petals of the four-leaf clover, we have one side where the stitches are upright and the tops of the stitches are on top, and the other side where the stitches are laying on their sides and the tops of the stitches are over to the side. If you're left-handed, they'll be going the other way, but because I'm right-handed, they'll be going to the left. And it's the same with every one of the petals. All of them have to be that way. If they are not, then you need to rip out and start over because you missed something somewhere. This is what has to happen. This is what works for the process. Okay. At this point, we will pause the video. Okay, if you are making the blanket, you are on this video now, and this is the way you will continue your blocks. You will work just like you're starting a whole new row. Make your first block of the new row. Okay, very important to, especially for the blanket, very important to put markers in. And you need one marker that is different for your side that for the peak where the it begins and ends. This one needs a different marker and it needs to run up, because you'll get to a point where it looks different and it can look confusing and you go, oh yeah, it's supposed to look confusing because I'm at the end and this is what I need to do. Okay, so we're gonna, for now, just kind of get this in here out of the way. We can take it out later. For the others, whatever stitch markers you have, and we're going to be working on this side, so it's a good idea to put them here. And for doing the blanket, it is really beneficial to move these up also. Now, if you want to use different colors of yarn or something, that would be fine too. And in fact, that's probably the easiest way to move them up, because you can loop it through back and forth and you can see it from both sides, which is a plus. Because this one I'm going to put over this way, like that, and let it go up the side. Okay, so we have our markers. We are making our first block. Just like a normal corner-to-corner block. Okay? So, for every block, or every round after this, you will flip to the back. You are working into the back of the stitches of the row below. I'm going to bring this up here so I can see it when I get back. Slip stitch, and when you're working up the sides, you just make regular corner to corner stitches going up the sides. With a blanket, you know, you could have 15 or 20 going up the side easily, even for a baby blanket. So for the first block, it's obvious you've got a space to work into, and you do a normal block with your chain two and your three double crochets. Now you need something to work into for the block starting down this side. And this is where it's different. This is why you need the markers to remind yourself that you're doing something different. Because you can get into the zone when you're working up the side and you've done 15 or 20 up the side and you get to the top and you're not really paying attention. And so that's what needs to happen. You need to put a fourth double crochet in there. Or if you want, you can use a half double. It is totally your choice. And chain up two and work your first block of the side. And then you just work as normal down the sides until you get to the next peak. And work your first block. Add a fourth double crochet or half double, your choice. Chain two and work your block around the double crochet. And you're set up to go down the other side. And I'm going to pause the video and come back to the end of the round and start again, showing you how to join. Okay, I have completed the round. Join. Do a normal corner to corner. Block. And then I again find the it's easier with this than it is with the hook. Find two loops of that slip stitch and work a half double crochet into there to fill in the gap. And then join to the very first block. And that is done. And if you want at any point to join another yarn, you could join it to here, or you could actually join it to any of them and do the same process where you just chain up, do your block, turn, so you're working into the back, and I suggest you move your markers up and start your next round. Same way we did, that was round three. Same way we did round three. So, and this is the same for the blanket and for the hat through this point. Alright, so I have been playing with the inside out, corner to corner, square or blanket. I suppose it could be made in smaller squares and joined after you finish off the edges. Or you can make a whole blanket. This is going to be a baby blanket. And it's worsted weight yarn, Red Heart Super Saver for the pink, and a very old thing, a pound of love that was donated to the senior center. And they're both worsted weight, and they actually feel pretty much the same as far as softness, but I know they'll both soften up after being washed. So this is the progress so far, and I'm putting this in to the middle of the video. I'm doing it after it's actually a couple days ago that I did the video for the beginning and showing how to do the rounds and so forth. This specifically is going to be a video to show how to carry up the yarn and get it to not show. So what I did was I started the blanket here with the pink and did the four setup sections, the setup rounds, I guess you would call them. And then I did round three, so there were three rows of the pink. And then I did three rows of white and joining, let's see, the pink, beginning and end of round is here. And when I started the white, I started the white over here, opposite from where the pink is. So that when the yarn is being carried up, it's being carried up on its own side. The pink is being carried up here, and when I was working pink, the white was being carried up through the edges of these. If I pull on it, you can see that. Maybe that light, now it's in my eyes, but there is white inside of those stitches. If you pull them back into place, you don't see the white. And it's a very easy way to carry up the yarn. So I'm going to demonstrate that. I have crocheted around and gotten it set up. Okay, pull that up a little bit. I like to use these clips. They're just little girl hair clips. I had this clipped off so it wouldn't come undone. I like to put the little tongue through the final loop and then just put it on the project and it'll stay where you put it, out of the way, whatever. But now we're going to work with it, so we will come up here and just like on all of our peaks, we do our chain two and do the first block. And I need to go in, I know, because that's why I'm redoing this video. Here, I'm trying to get the blanket out of the way so it's easier to see with the background. Okay, I gotta be conscious and try and stay on in the camera range. Okay, so I make a normal block. All right, so I've made the normal block. What I'm going to do now is take my clip and clip this out of the way. And actually, I'm going to take my working yarn and clip that out of the way too, just so it's not interfering in the video. Wouldn't have to be this careful just for myself, but I want to be able to show what's going on. Okay, I have this loop down here and I have made it, this one's already been adjusted. I made it the length that I wanted so that it looked like the other stitches, or you know, the other blocks where they came together, and it prevented the pink from being from showing through. And what I did was, here, I'll take that out and show you. Okay, there's a very long loop that's just like a super long chain that's from here to here. And this is the next chain. I make one more chain and then I pull it tight so that that first chain disappears into there. Then I take and make a chain about the length that I want and a little bit extra and bring it up and clip it so it's longer, a little bit longer than it needs to be for here. Okay, now this is key. You have to take and put the carried up yarn, all of it, including the working part, which is why I'm clipping that with it. Because one time I ended up with the work, I had to rip out the whole thing and go back because I had the working yarn still down underneath this loop. And there was no way to get it up there without actually working around it first. So you want the working yarn, your loop all up and out of the way so that you can take the color you're working with now and put it underneath, and the carried yarn is on top, all of it. Okay? So now you just make a chain around the yarn. So you have captured it in between the other yarn. That's your first chain. You make your second chain and work around this as if it were that extra stitch that we make. And then you would continue on down. Totally up to you about whether you join it and not join it, adjust it now and if you want to do that you can, or you can wait until you've gone all the way around and adjust it and pull it out, adjust this part and then pull it out and get it ready for the next one. I will show you right now though how to adjust it, but it is totally acceptable to go all the way around before adjusting it, because it's not going to go anywhere. It's clipped down, and that's why these clips are important. They're better than regular stitch markers for this, and they're cheap, like a dollar at Family Dollar, or now a dollar and a quarter at Dollar Tree. Okay, so this is what needs to be adjusted down in this section now, right here. I need to tighten and make this loop smaller. And to do that, I can take this out, put that in, and I can, whoops. If you're working on a surface, you can kind of let it rest, or you can hold it there in your hand. And you basically just pull on the working yarn until you get that down to where the gap is about what the other gaps are in the normal corner-to-corner joints at the peaks. So that looks about right. So now, having that there, I make another chain. And now what I need to do is I need to make that loop that I still had on there go down. And so I have to, it's a levering problem. So you figure out which loop to pull. And I think it's this one back here. See how I'm making that go down in there? So it's just the right length. I don't want it poking up above like it was when I had it on the hook. So now it's adjusted. It's right where I want it. The very top of that loop. All that is basically a long chain. Now I can take it, make this a little bit smaller, and do a chain. And then I take and I pull this back loop again and I tighten that chain down totally. So it's basically a knot at the top of that loop. And then I can bring this up and clip it and it's set. It doesn't really matter how long the loop is at this point. It's just set so it's out of the way. So when I come back up, I can go on with what I need to do and do the same thing over again. The rest of the round is just done normally, the way I've shown you in the video. Normal corner-to-corner stitches up the sides. The join that I showed you in the with the blue yarn to do the peaks, and you come back around, and this is row one and row two here. So when we come back around, we're going to be finishing doing the last one of these adjustments and going all the way back here and finishing your white yarn, your rounds for the white yarns, and then you would flip your flip it around and start working after you've joined and clipped the white yarn so that it won't come undone while you're working with the pink. Then you would just go around with the pink, and when you got to the pink, or the pink over to where the white is tied off, the same, it would be tied off just like this with a couple of chains, big chains, and something to hold it tightly so it's not gonna go back in or, you know, come undone. And I love these clips for that because they really do hold. And you just keep doing that, and it's not a hard process, and it looks that I tried a few other things on one of the hats, and it was awkward and it didn't look pretty. It wasn't something that I wanted to share because I was sure somebody else could figure out a better way to do it than what I was doing it on the hats. But with this, I haven't tried it, but I'm thinking that if you wanted to do something with, you know, like up to four stitches or four colors, you've got four corners here, and each corner could be a place where you start a different color. Like if you wanted to do pink and white and yellow and green, say, for whatever, you could start each one at a different point on the compass, so to speak. Like we've got north and white is south, and you could do one from the east and the other from the west, whatever. I think it would work to do that. It would. I will say though, just with two yarns, because they stay connected, they do get twisted around each other. That is the process for carrying up the yarn if you want to change colors. And so, happy crocheting, and I will be, I know from looking at the other videos that I'll be returning to the blue to finish off and show you how to finish the edges and the peaks, because it just looks awkward having it that way. So there is a little bit more to do. So, hey, the other thing that's important when you're doing your final round of, and I'm going to get off and do another final round. That's the way. Well, actually, I'll show you a final round and I'll finish it. That's what I'll do. Here we go. Hey, you do your final round this way. First block should get six. One, two, three, four, five, six. This will leave you a chain three for the point. And there. Okay. Turn and join to the back. Work your sides just like normal with just the two chains. And when you get up to the top, to your peak or your point, you join. Chain two here is fine. Do your normal block. Add your extra half double or double. And now you chain three. You do this on all of the blocks for the second block of the peaks. Chain three. And work your block. And I'm going to get off and finish this, and I'll show you why that isn't. Whoops, that's four. Don't need more. I'll get off and finish and come back and explain it. Okay. So I got the round where I chained six for the first block and chained up three for the second blocks of all of the peak. And now we will show you why that's important. And while I was off camera, I've been up and downstairs twice, so I'm a little out of breath. I just got back up here and the phone rang. And so I'm back down and back up. So, okay, so we are all the way around. I did go get my 6.0, which is one step down in size. Now, in order to even out, which would enable you to put on any border you wanted, you turn your work. This evening out row is done into the backs, the stitches. And for the first part, we're just gonna slip stitch over to get into position. And you can do either one, two, three, four, or maybe in three, it doesn't really matter. Okay, now there are multiple ways that you can accomplish evening this out. A lot depends on the thickness of your yarn, your tension, hook size, all sorts of things. So I'm gonna give you options, and you need to work with your yarn and your hook and your tension and come up with one, especially for a blanket, this is important. Come up with one that is going to lay flat without buckling up, but because there's too many, or pulling in because there aren't enough. So I like to fill in this gap by going into that slip stitch. For me, it's not an option. You may skip it if you need to. You can do it that way. I'm not going to show you that way. It's just I don't like the gap that you get if you don't go into this one. Okay, your next stitch, this is a double crochet. Next stitch can either be a double crochet or a half double crochet. Try it both ways, see what you like best. We'll put a half in there. Next one is a half double crochet, and then a single crochet. Okay, and you do three or four of those and see how it's leaning. If it seems to be bowing out a lot or buckling, don't count the points because we will deal with the points. But anyway, do a few. Another alternative, if it's buckling, if that's too many stitches, is to do a double, a half double, and then do two single crochet, two together. And you can do it either that way or the normal way, where you go into both and then yarn over and go through both. Either way, that works. And that will be one less stitch. Whatever you decide on, you know, after you've done three or four, or, you know, half of one side of your blanket with one and half of that side with the other, and decide and rip out and do the whole thing the way that looks best without, you know, where you have enough stretch and enough stitches for this yarn, doing the taking that one stitch out, it is not going to work. But I show you that for different yarns. Okay, so we come up to this one and we do whatever you decide on, you do it all the way along the side. And okay, this is our final one on this side. Okay, now because we did three chains, we don't have to fudge. We have three stitches on this side to work into. One, two, three chains. We have the center slip stitch to work into, and then three stitches on the other side. And it's the same now with all the peaks, because I did that final round with the chain up three and starting the very first one with a chain six to make the very first block. So we're going to have enough stitches. Otherwise, if you don't do that, you end up doing messing around. Okay, multiple options for doing the side or the points. You can do a slip stitch in there and a single crochet. That seems to look okay. And then do a half double. And then in this last chain, you get a double crochet. Now that looks bulgy. Don't like that. So we'll take it out. And we'll get rid of that slip, or the, we'll just simply do a slip stitch, and then we'll put the single crochet in the one next to it, and a half double in that same stitch. And that seems to line up better for this yarn. May work for yours too. Now into this one, you work the double crochet at least one, possibly two. I'm going to leave it with one because I'm going to try one that I thought about when I was writing things out for one of the patterns for the peak. Okay, yarn over twice because we're going to do a treble. Now, if one treble seems enough to you, you can just start and repeat these stitches in reverse going down this side. Or the other thing I wanted to try was wrapping around three times, and I think it's called a double treble, and doing three stitches in the center. And the middle one is a double treble, and then we go back to a treble crochet. And then your double. And that brings it out to a nice point. And then in this one, I think we did the half double, and then the single, and then a slip stitch. And you try it if it seems to look right to you. Fine. If not, go back and try it. That does seem a little bit bulky. So I would probably go back and try it with just the one treble in the center. And then I would go on down and repeat whatever I decided on this side, I would do on all three sides. And whatever I came up with for the first peak, you repeat that with the other three peaks so that it looks uniform all the way around and your blanket is finished. So, and with the blanket, it is important that I did a video for the shawl, and it's important not to get too many stitches on the sides. For most yarns, I think having four stitches along the side is going to even it out. And then also you can kind of even it out later with an extra row of single crochet to finish it off, or reverse single crochet crab stitch. That would look nice around the edge too. Or you could put a whole different border on. This sets it up nicely to be able to put a border on and have it look okay. So, and because you keep reversing with each one, both sides basically look the same. Okay, that is finishing off for the blanket. I have completed the inside out, corner to corner baby blanket. It now measures 27 inches, which gives me just enough to do an inch and a half border on each side. So it's 30 inches, which is what was the specification on the donations, whoever's receiving it wanted. So what I wanted to explain was when I went to do the finishing round to even it out and get it ready for a border, after I had completed one side, a point, and went partway down another side, I realized that there were too many stitches. It was bowing like this. So, I mean, you couldn't get it to lay flat, and I knew it was not going to be fixable with going down another couple of hook sizes. So I ripped out what I had and went back, and I've finished it off with three stitches for each block. And that worked wonderfully. And it's all set now to do a border. And I am pleased with the way it has turned out. So that is the corner to corner, or I should say inside out corner to corner baby blanket. Happy crocheting!